All right, why don't we start in the room here with questions for Coach?
Coach, any updates on Carlos and Tyson?
Yeah, too early to really give you a good, you know, a good update. So nothing really yet. I mean, obviously Tyson's been working hard in rehab and so forth. So, you know, that just continues. Carlos, we don't have an answer yet.
Now with a day and a half to sit on Saturday, is there anything that really stands out to you?
You know, I mean, it's another one of those scenarios where we're down at half and just keep fighting and get it all the way back to even Steven and then, you know, go to the overtime and, you know, is what it is. So couldn't be happier with the way the guys are competing, the way they're working, and made some plays. Obviously, offensively, I thought we had a pretty good night, just kind of going through the night. Defensively, first half, we were not very good, and then shut them out in the second half. So, you know, good response from them, because if they don't do that, we got no shot.
There has been a theme throughout the year, maybe slower starts from the team, that you guys sometimes come back to bite you at the end. How do you guys as a staff try to remedy that between the players and play a complete game?
Well, you know, the first series of the game, it's three and out. So that's about as fast as you're going to get. But, yeah, you know, I mean, there's some of that going on. But the bottom line is sustaining it throughout the first half is really been the issue. You know, I mean, you know, we battled back, you know, in our first home game to get it to 31-28 with, I don't know, 9 minutes to go. And, you know, we just kept battling again Saturday, you know, evening. So, you know, just gotta keep working it. But we've talked about, you know, speeding up practice a little bit, but you know, we do that thunderstruck period virtually every single day that we're in pads. So I'm not sure that's really the answer.
Penalties have been a pretty big issue this year. Is it this one thing? What do you got to do to kind of clean up?
I think it's all of it, you know, because it's across the board. It's offensively, it's defensively, it's in the kicking game. You know, it's across the board. You know, we've just got to do a better job with our discipline, and you know, go from there.
Looking ahead, what have you guys seen from Arkansas State on the offensive and the defensive side?
On the offensive side, you know, they're going with a new quarterback who's a true freshman. Obviously, has some running ability and has shown that ability in the last game and a half. He also has the ability to throw the ball down the field. And, you know, so obviously we got to be ready for not only the run game part of it and his ability to run, but also, you know, throwing the deep ball. So we've got to be ready for that as well.
You mentioned the offense and the strides that they've taken and how good they were on Saturday. I think it was 8 of your 9 drives, not including the end of the first half, got into New Mexico territory.
Yep.
But I mean, what do you got to do to punch those drives?
I know. I mean, that's, you know, that's the big piece. You know, we got to get into the red zone too. When we get in the red zone, we got to score touchdowns. You know, that's, anybody that asks you that, that's what they're going to say to you, and it certainly holds true for us.
I know last week it was brought up the possibility of having a two quarterback system on Saturday. Is that still something that you guys are maybe considering, or is it still too early?
You know, let's just get through our injury situation and see where the heck we're at, and you know, but it's a nice thought, you know. Certainly wouldn't be that difficult to do. Hassan did a good job too. So, you know, I mean, we have, you know, really happy with the with where we're at there, we just, you know, like you said, we got to finish. We got to finish with touchdowns.
Did you see enough from Ahmad in that short period where if Puma and Carlos were unavailable, that you'd be the guy that you'd
mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel really good, really comfortable with him at the helm. I thought he played really well. I thought he competed, and I thought he, ran the show really well as well. So I didn't see a lot of weaknesses there.
All right, we'll take some questions from Zoom.
Go ahead, Rich.
Don, just got a question about Billy Wooden. Just talk about his progress from last year. His numbers are pretty impressive.
Yeah, you know, the good thing with Billy is we're kind of getting the really healthy Billy Wooden. You know, last year was, a year removed off his ACL injury. So obviously there's that period of time where, you know, you got to get comfortable, you got to get your strength back, and you got to be at full speed. And, we're seeing that guy this year for sure. We didn't see that guy last year until maybe the very end, but we're seeing that guy right now for sure.
Okay, a quick follow-up to that. I've always been told that a good nose tackle makes the people around him better. They have the better numbers because they're getting the double teams. Is Cletus filling that role for you? Being
yeah.
Bolder in the middle of your defense?
Yeah, he and Beckwith both, sharing time in there, and both of them working at that position. So, and Billy, to some degree, can get in there and, get his hands dirty too. So, we've got a number of guys that can man that spot, but, really happy with those two. You know, you singled out the inside defensive line position. Has been playing pretty solid.
Quinn.
Coach, obviously Aston comes in late in the game and makes a big impact on that final drive in order to lead the team to tie the game. How important is it to have a kind of mobile quarterback in those situations for him to kind of roll out of the pocket and create those big plays like we saw at the end of the game last night?
It's really important. When we went about last year, when we went about our recruiting process, we were searching for guys that were veteran presence and could, come in and take a college offense and move it up and down the field. I think we've done that. And then obviously the young quarterback that we were going to take had to have the ability to run, but also run our offense. And he's certainly showing that he's capable of running our offense and, at the highest level. So really happy with the minutes he responded with. And, he certainly gave us a chance.
Hello, Kevin.
Hey, Coach, how you doing?
Hi, Kev.
The slow starts, particularly at home, is that maybe just guys maybe being too tight or trying to do too much early on for the home crowd?
That your guess is as good as mine, to be honest. We've talked about it as a staff. We actually got off on the right foot. We were 3-and-out on defense the other night. But, I think there's some, delay there from just getting into it and just letting it go and getting our rhythm. And, for us, it's everything counts. Everything matters. We're analyzing everything, trying to rectify situations. So with all those things, that we're kind of evaluating, everything counts. So, we're looking at it all right now.
Go ahead, Rich.
Hey, Don, when your team goes into overtime, do you just employ your red zone package, or is there a separate package for overtime?
No, we'll have plays that we'll utilize in overtime, but we'll also use those plays, you know, in our goal line short yardage situation, depending on where we are on the field. But, you know, when you get down, you know, when you're down in, you know, there's some similarities of plays that you can utilize for sure. But, you know, that's when you're at crunch time and it's down to, you know, a couple yards or whatever. But, yeah, there's some similarities for sure, some crossover.
Hello, Quinn.
Coach, can you can you talk to us a little bit about the decision to kick in overtime on the 4th and 2? Did you trust your defense? Like you said, they've been really good in the second half of that game, holding New Mexico scoreless. So did you kind of have faith in them in order to get off the field and get the ball back in the offense ends?
You're right on all counts. Yep, you were right on all counts. That was the tact, that was the thought, and that was, you know, obviously that was the result we were looking for.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thanks, Coach.
Billy, defense in the second half, I think, or third quarter, sorry, 3 out of 5 games held the opposition scoreless. What has made the defense such a second half unit so far this season?
It's kind of like a goal of ours, kind of just take pride in having third quarter shutouts, especially this past game. We just went to locker room, made some adjustments, kind of got the guys fired up, and we just knew that's what we had to do to even be, like, give ourselves a chance to even win the game.
What's it going to take, you know, being so efficient in the third quarter, what's it going to take from you guys as a unit to kind of copy that gameplay and make it happen in the first couple quarters of the game? You guys have gotten yourselves into a couple holes these last couple weeks.
I would say just start faster, just get them kinks out the way early. Just teams are going to make plays sometimes. Just how you will respond is kind of everything. So I would just say once we kind of had them trials and tribulations, we just get back on our feet and just make plays. That's all it really is. We'll just really start fast and just being able to adapt. Once a team may draw something up, that works.
You personally, you've had a tremendous year. You got another great game on Saturday. All right, you're playing with a lot of confidence. Try to put into words what this season individually has meant to you, especially, you know, battling with injuries throughout your career.
It's been a good ride for me this season. I mean, it's my last ride, so it's like I just wanted to leave it all out on the field, but it's really just giving props to all my coaches. I mean, they kind of helped me get in this position, and then mainly my body just feeling better than compared to last year and the previous year. So just hard work and dedication. So this season meant a lot to me.
Defensive line, there hasn't been too much turnover, at least in the offseason, compared to some of the other units on the team. Mm-hmm. How has that helped you guys having, you know, guys come back and, you know, kind of that starting unit being similar to what it was last year?
We kind of just got a more of a core group of guys that kind of just been in the system, and like we all know each other, like Cletus Mathurin, Aaron Beckwith, Hugo Cogg, as far as the interior D tackles. So we've been playing with each other for years. So it's like it's a good chemistry we have, and then like when you bring in the new pieces on, like JB or Bradley from last year, just fine tuning certain things. It's the chemistry, I feel like, it helps us a lot.
Curious your reaction to the long touchdown at the end of the game there, you being on the sideline, just hope you guys get another chance to get back out there. What was just your reaction to Ahmad's long touchdown decision?
It was crazy. I mean, it was I don't even know how to explain it, to be honest. It was kind of like oh, that really just happened. Just so we all some of the D line, we just was all huddled up, just hoping we get the 2-point conversion and just give ourselves an opportunity. So we just all was excited, so.
All right, we can go to questions on Zoom.
Hello, Rich.
Hi, Billy. Just a question I asked Coach. How much does Aaron and Cletus doing the dirty work, you know, on the nose, kind of open things up and create tackling opportunities for the rest of you guys?
I mean, they definitely play a key role in the defense just because they probably get most of the double teams and most of they do have to do a lot of the dirty work. So the three tech position is more like you can make more plays, you can take more shots, whereas to nose, you might got to sit in the double team a little more. And you have you can take less shots, but your role in the defense is so important just because a lot of teams want to run up the A-gap and run up the midline. So they definitely play a huge role. Like I just was saying, them guys we've been playing with each other for a while, so we all kind of know, like, yeah, I might not make this play here, but you might make it, or it might be roles reversed, where I might face a double team and you may get a one-on-one block. So we just them guys are important to me, so.
Well, Quinn?
Billy, looking ahead to next week where you guys play Arkansas State here at home, they obviously have a pretty mobile quarterback and they're true freshmen. What are you guys doing to prepare for that kind of a quarterback, which is kind of a different system from what you guys have seen this year?
As far as X and O's, we haven't really got too deep into it yet, but I felt like we were just handling like every other quarterback like that we know can kind of run a little bit, or that's a mobile quarterback, just focusing on your keys and just doing what you're supposed to do. And that's really what it all comes down to is just doing what you're supposed to do. Because we have stuff in place to protect ourselves from guys like that. And just, it's just small thing as far as the defensive line. You know your pass rush presence got to be there because he can scramble. Or if they want to do QB power, QB counter, just run the quarterback in general. Yeah, it might add an extra blocker, but we got stuff in the defense to protect ourselves from that. So just regular preparation of how we would prepare for any other team.
Hi, Kevin.
Hey, Billy. You mentioned the slow starts, and I'm just curious, is there a sense maybe, you know, guys being too tight at home especially, or trying to do too much at home?
I wouldn't say necessarily being tight. I just feel like we had a lot of injuries this past week, so a lot of young guys and new faces kind of getting their first lick of college ball. So sometimes a game may move a little quicker than usual. But just once you get your cleats in the ground, you just start focusing on your keys and just focusing on what you're being coached to do, everything will fall in place. So probably more nerves, but once you shake them off, you'll be fine.
Thanks, Billy.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.